Also and known for its eminent personalities such as Dwaram Venkataswamy Naidu, a music master, and Adipatla Narayan Dasu, who is also called as Adipati. The last six to come here all the way from Amaravati to this place.
Sri Chekati, Justice Sri Chekati Maganagandhar Rai Garu, to deliver his speech.
Although I am very much eager to address the gathering from the bottom of my heart as a person hailing from this district. Due to time constraint, I will try to cut short my speech. And I know that you are all very eagerly waiting to hear our Honorable Chief Justice, the message of Justice Arup Kumar Goswami. It is indeed my great pleasure and a great pride to stand before you all on this happy occasion before the guest gathering and address you all as a judge who hails from this district and as a son of this soil. Honorable Chief Justice, we must really thank him on this occasion at the outset.
On the soil, there was another soil of the sun who was supposed to grace this occasion, that is Justice Durga Prasad Rao ji, but because of some unavoidable circumstances he could not make it in today's function. Mr. G. Gopi, Principal District and Session Judge Vijayanagaram, Mr. Sanjeev Rao, President Bar Association, judicial officers and staff of the district judiciary, senior advocates, members of the bar, members of the Advocate Clerks Association, government officials present, economic, cultural and political achievements in the Women's International Day, which is due to be held on 8th of March. It focuses conversation about women's achievements and global gender inequalities into focus. And such conversations can make the world a much more equal place for everyone. Although it's quite some time since I was elevated as a judge, mentally I am still associating myself with the members of the bar. And whenever I visit any bar, and today is no exception, fond memories flood the recesses of my mind. I transport myself to the good old days when I was a member of the bar. where women are honored, dignity blossoms there. Our culture is such that we respect our women, but ironically, today's context, we see crimes against women increasing day by day. Why this has happened is not an occasion for us to dilate, but fact remains that we cannot remain a silent spectator when crimes against women, children, are increasing day by day. We have to take proactive steps. Legislations have been enacted, and it is an outcome of that process which has resulted in the concept of setting up special courts for women and for children. With the inauguration of these two courts today, I feel that perhaps a long-standing requirement of this judiciary has come to be fulfilled. And I think the stakeholders will be much benefited. Brother Justice Roy had dwelt upon a number of issues. In fact, not only Brother Justice Roy, I consider myself to be extremely fortunate that in the short span of 2 months, and I mean it, the kind of camaraderie that has developed between us, it's a wonderful experience to have. They all come and share their difficulties in the districts that they head, the kind of solutions that can be worked out, the way to go forward. I think it's just simply a wonderful experience for me. It's my good fortune, and I, in this public forum, acknowledge my gratitude to all my brother judges. And I'm confident that in the days to come also, I will have such unstinted cooperation from my brother judges, so that we can work together for the betterment of the judiciary in this state. I have noted down a couple of points in today's context raised by Brother Justice Roy. I can tell you that this will have my close attention. Not only this bar, the pending issues, things to be done in respect of all the 13 districts so far as judiciary is concerned, I will devote my time, apart from my devotion of time, to judicial work. This I can assure you, and I will do what is just and proper for the good of the system to develop and grow from strength to strength. With these few words, I thank you all for being present on this occasion. And lastly, I apologize for not being on time. Keeping time is very, very crucial for everything. It is not that we delayed our departure from Rajahmundry. We started on time, but the traffic in the way was such that it crossed our estimation, as a result of which we are about half an hour late. I apologize again and for bearing with us with patience. Thank you so much. Namaskar.